Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. And there are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. I don't know which is worse. Just take your pick.
Easy, damn it. Keep him in the boat. Canal's got enough shit in it as it is. Good. Keep him coming. Okay. What is it?
I think that last one was moving.
What?
Yeah, the little one.
Not possible. I inspected them myself. Keep working.
Well, he ain't moving no more.
Attention, watchmen. This district is now considered a highly infected area. Residents are to be escorted to adjacent neighborhoods or delivered for immediate deportation to the flooded district. Remain in position until qualified personnel have completed the removal of infected bodies.
Half the city's dead. We'll make it 3 more months.
Garbage, 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 garbage. All of it.
I told you the lies go on the left. They've always gone on the left. You never listen.
I think the little birdies are sad today. Dear? Is that you, my dear husband? Oh, my eyes aren't what they used to be. Have you seen my little birdies? Oh, the dear things must be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here. Oh, my, my, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either. Granny Rags, let us in. Ah, well, they'll go away again if they know what's good for them. But what a bother. Here's the key to the front door, love. You'll see to those ruffians, won't you? I think the little birdies are sad today. I told you the number. They've always gone on the left. You never listen.
Let us in, Granny. I bet she can't even hear us. She's blind, not deaf. We're here to do your washing. She's not stupid either. Have it your way. We're here to take your money, Granny. We're wasting our time. How much could she have? She digs in trash for a living. Let's get a drink. I'm dry as an overseer's prick. She's been digging for 80 years. Must have found something. Hear that, Granny? Whatever you got, Slackjaw gets a cut. Nothing personal. Just fuck you. Come on, spread out. Oh, I'll find you. Help me look for him. I know you're here. Where are you?
Go on the left. They've always gone on the left. You never listen. Oh, my dear. I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave man. Listen, Granny has a birthday present for you. I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you. Go on. It's upstairs, on the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it. Remember how we used to dance? Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to come. I think the little birdies are sad today. Oh, no, that's not a nice thing. Just garbage. All. I hope you like the little gift I got for you. It's the least I could do for turning those louts away. I can't bear these Bottle Street children. Ruffians, every last one of them. Rotten apples. And that Slackjaw is the worst of the lot. You know what I just thought of? You could do something else for me. Another little favor. And I'd give you another present. Another lovely rune carved from the bones of a dead whale. Do you remember my doctor, dear? Dr. Galvani? Now there was a clever man. He's got all sorts of nasty rat guts and disease in his laboratory. Wouldn't it be a shame if some of that mess found its way into the Bottle Street gang's elixir still? Teach him. See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first. Galvani lives on Clavering Boulevard, or at least he used to. Those were the days. Now run off. My baby birdies are hungry. So precious. But they're shy. You'll have to go or they won't come.
Let me know if you want to gamble on the hounds again.
Another night, another patrol with you.
Wait, did you touch the door handle to Dr. Galvani's lab?
Yeah, I think so.
Then you have to scrub. The rats get their vital essences everywhere, the doctor said.
Vital essences? Does that mean guts?
I think so. So your hands need scrubbing. You're unclean.
Unclean? That's nonsense. Can't we just...
No, I told you. With rubbing alcohol or white vinegar.
All right, all right. What is he doing there all day? Ambrose says he breeds rats that carry the plague.
Your friends are ignorant. The doctor is a brilliant man. If anyone can save this city, it's him.
The royal physician is going to save us. Iyer's new elixir is twice as good against the plague.
I don't understand how Galvani can admire Sokolov. Royal physician or not, I hear tell he's a beast. A superstitious philanderer who spends more time with prostitutes than he does in the laboratory.
Is this what it's going to be like when we're married? It is, isn't it?
I hope not. I'm telling you now, I don't have the endurance for it.
After all.
It's just ridiculous. Stupid rats. Plague. Elixir. Bunch of crap.
Oh, my God.
I told her to keep the children inside. I told her.
Obviously, the plague rat is distinct from the ordinary rat, but in what respect? Its size and the coarseness of its fur, and I believe in intelligence, although the experiments there are not complete. The Andrew Zoological Survey describes only the ordinary rat, which means plague rats have only been here for 5 or 7 years at most. This was not a gradual migration. Could they have been introduced on purpose? Perhaps by a foreign power.
Thank you.
This whole place has gone to the hounds. This whole place has gone.